The wizened old turtle peers up at you inquisitively as she makes her slow, slow path across the beach.
Smells good, eh? Smells so good. Can you smell it? Silly. Silly. I mean the rich, warm, red smell of raw meat. Quartermistress Anna, saint of a woman, sometimes throws me some for dinner. Now I smell so much in that building over there. I can hear it too. Covered with flies. My favorite. Adds a bit of crunch. Each to their own. I look at you. A guard woken, hanging out on the beach, talking to a turtle. What's that all about?
The turtle nods her head sagely and tremulously turns to resume her dignified procession towards dinner.
Is that... Oh, Void, it is a shrieker!
The statue looms in the shadowy darkness as the tears dampen your fingertips. Carved from unfamiliar metal in an alien style, this mysterious object yet glows with a pulsating inner light that is familiar to you. The unmistakable brilliance of Source.
Whoa, what was that?
Magisters. What are they up to?
He was a saboteur and paid the price. Do you want to make the same end as he did?
I'll get him.
Keep close watch, lads. Mind those torches now. We need more barrels to bring down this blasted wall.
Nothing yet, madam. The black.
Do you want to meet the same end as he did?
Thank you.
The Black Ring captive you executed was the only one who knew how to operate it.
Do you want to make the same end as he did?
mine.
Guess I know what I need to do now.
Impressive. A barrel
from somewhere deep within the inner workings of the machine, the machine churns into life. Gears rotate and pistons hiss from somewhere within its metal housing. It settles into a slow metallic chug, ready for the next lever, perhaps. The machine churns into life. Gears rotate and it settles into a slow There is a sudden shriek.
That's a lot of firepower to stockpile in one place.
After all this time, I never thought I'd walk our halls again. It is immaculate. There is no trace of the filth that has infected this world.
Ralik, I used to pray to you when I was young. Huh, Xantetza, the goddess of mirth, worshipped by imps. God of the Orcs, Vrogir. It's Amadia, the mother of wizards.
Blessed Zolstis, an elegant god for our elegant people.
Duna, the stoutest of the seven. No wonder the dwarves pray to him. Tercendelius, poet.
Well, that wasn't right.
Tercendelius, poet and patron god of the elves. Duna, the stoutest of the seven. No wonder the dwarves pray to him. Strange. I've never seen anything like this before. god of the orcs, Vrogir.
The curious sculpture comes alive as you reach out to touch it. It thrums with power and throws flickering dancing shadows against the walls. The carving is covered in strange glyphs that feel oddly familiar. They surround a gently glowing stone that makes you think of the night sky rolled into a ball. Trying to read the symbols, you hear a faint whispering at the back of your mind, as if you're listening to the echoes of a past age. Your mind swims, and for a moment, the glyphs become clear. You read, "Our first lord's babes with power glowed, our seconds born in blood that flowed. Our thirds young to the wind return, our fourths to glowing flames adjourn. Our fifth lord's cubs with minds were blessed, our sixths had brawn beyond the rest. Our seventh's brood spread from earth to glen, and thus no king shall rise again." You try to hold your focus as the whispering echo fades, but the letters waver, contorting and merging until they're nothing but meaningless glyphs once more.
A riddle from the past. Or maybe a riddle about the past. Ralik, I used to pray to you when I was young. Xantetza, the goddess of mirth, worshipped by imps.
Blessed Zolstissen, an elegant god for our elegant people.
It's Amadia, the mother of wi-
Well, that wasn't right.
It's Amadia, the mother of wizards. Ralik, I used to pray to you when I was young. The god of the orcs, Vrogir. What a way to die, down here in this darkness. Poor soul. Strange. I've never seen anything like this before.
Blessed Zolstissen.
Duna, elegant the stoutest of the seven, Terse and Delius, poet and patron god of the elves.
Zantetsa.
Well, that wasn't right.
Ralik, I used to pray to you when I was young. Duna, the stoutest of the seven. No wonder the dwarves pray to him. Ter Sendelius, poet and patron god of the elves.
Blessed Zolstis, an elegant god for our elegant people.
God of the Orcs, Vrogir. Huh. Zantetsa, the goddess of mirth, worshipped by imps. It's Amadia, the mother of wi-
Well, that wasn't right.
It's Amadia, the mother of wizards. Ter Sendelius, poet and patron god of the elves. Duna, the stoutest of the seven.
Blessed
Zorstus. No wonder the dwarves pray to him.
An elegant god for our elegant people.
Xantetza, the god of the orcs, Vrogir. Ralik, I used to pray to you when I was young.
That's it! We're through! What in the name of Lucian's prize pig is going on here? I wonder what they did in life to deserve such a resting place.
As the creature crawls from the sarcophagus, you hear a gasp of breath. Fane steps forward, never taking his eyes off her.
I must speak to her. It is vital. Please, stand aside.
You hear a gasp from the creature as Fane steps forward. It speaks in a hissing, clicking language that seems both completely alien and somewhat familiar. Fane raises his head and responds in the same jolting, clicking tongue. He seems to be pleading with the creature, his hands outstretched. The creature looks down at him and shrieks in rage. Her gestures are quick, strong, and violent. Whatever she said, it seems to have devastated your friend. The verbal barrage continues, but something changes within Fane. He looks up, and golden light pours from his skull. When he speaks next, you understand every word, but you're not sure the words are his own.
Aetira, Aetira. I had hoped to see you turn to dust in this tomb. Alone, forgotten, with only your secrets for comfort.
Lady Amadia? You possess him. Have you fallen so far that you seek shelter within that? Does your vessel even know what you did? The war you started? The greed and avarice that saw you betray the Eternals?
The glow fades, and Fane seems to return to himself. He staggers slightly, exhausted by everything that's happened. The creature turns away from him and, panting, turns to you.
It is still active, even after all these years. This is altogether too familiar.
As the creature crawls,
You
hear a gasp. Fane raised. The creature looks. The verbal aid.
Lead us your.
The glow. The creature.
It is still active, even after all these years. This is altogether too familiar.
As the creature crawls from the sarcophagus, you hear a gasp of
lead
does
the glow of the creature.
Thank you.
The air suddenly feels thick, like it's grown musty after concealing a lie for so long.
They lied. I can't believe it. I mean, of course they lied to you, look at you. But they also lied to me.
So, the gods are liars. I can't say I'm surprised.
Their tale is one of scholars becoming gods. If they could, we can. Which is rather excellent.
I wonder what they did in life to deserve such a resting place.